All right, so today I'm going to talk about Cogmaster. He's one of those frontline attackers. He was one of the ones they released when the game started. So he's a Fury frontline attacker. He really builds up his power actually really quickly. His skills are really nice, and he has a ton of attack, even higher than Totem Prince. So he has 7,700 life. So it's a decent amount, comparable to Light Warden, a little lower than Elder Mohawk, and then it's just about, that's a little less than Skullbuster. My Skullbuster's only a only purple, my Cogmaster's purple one, but I mean decent life. He has a kind of medium to lower energy gain, which isn't it's just, it's not bad. Medium attack speed and a super high attack is like the highest attack I think out of all my heroes. Totem Prince has an attack of 1,071, but obviously Totem Prince, his skills account for a lot. It's that the fact that he's doing the damage on the back line is a really big boost for him. So Cogmaster, his white skill experiment, numbers. He kicks the closest enemy back, dealing like a ton of damage. It's an insane attack. It does a ton of damage. Then it does extra damage if the target currently has another like debuff, like cursed, bleeding, anything like that. So it can do a ton of damage, can easily kill someone, if not take most of their life away. Stand firm, this hero can't be knocked back. Don't really like spending my time on that skill just because it doesn't happen a lot. Backup plan, hurls a grenade at the enemy with the highest threat, dealing a moderately high damage and stunning them for 5 seconds. The stun's really nice. But so he targets the person who's currently doing the most damage, so it takes them out of the game for a minute. And since he has such a high attack, he gets a chance to clear him up. So that's really nice because in 5 seconds, with his attack speed, he gets two attacks off, plus if he can get the experiment skill off, they're done for. Then this last skill, armor proficiency, it ignores up to 340 damage per attack. But it can't block more than half the attack's total damage. But this kind of helps him a lot. Even though he already has a really good high life, since he's a frontline and an attacker, so he's going to have a really high threat, this kind of, I guess, takes away some of that potential damage he can take. So it can't take away, I mean, if someone does a 2,000 damage attack to you, it's still going to hurt a ton. But he'll block 340 of that, which is really nice. And say you're getting attacked by someone with 400 attack, it would block 200 of it because it can't block more than half of the attack's total damage. But a really good skill, especially to try and, I guess, make it so the enemy's skills don't do as much damage against you. You can use Cogmaster with many different heroes. Some of my favorite combinations are Light Warden because of her healing ability and also her high threat. Feral Brute because he has an amazingly high life and high threat, so he can take away a lot of the damage from that. And also Elder Mohawk because if now I don't upgrade this skill personally, but Come At Me increases his threat by 100. So it takes all the threat away, or I guess it draws all the attention away from Cogmaster and gives Cogmaster a chance to use his skills. But he's one of my favorite heroes because he's such a high damaging character. Highly recommend working on him. Thanks for watching.